people, and this is their story. This year, Chevrolet celebrates 80 years of building dependable trucks, and America's love affair with the pickup seems stronger than ever. This program speaks to the hearts of truck fans everywhere. Although Chevy's official product introduction is months away, you're invited to get the inside scoop on its newest full-size pickup, the 1999 Chevy Silverado. In this sneak preview, you'll meet a special Chevy truck owner, baseball's Iron Man, and your host, Cal Ripken Jr.
Frankly, I'm kind of excited to see what they've done to my truck.
Get the story from an engineer's point of view.
One of our objectives up front was to double a brake light.
See actual GM testing. And visit the North American International Auto Show for an exclusive reveal of the new Silverado.
We stood true to what we believed in.
So stay tuned. In the next 30 minutes, you can become part of this new truck's history. Call anytime during the show to receive advance information on the new Silverado, request a free videotape of this preview, or just let us know what you think. As a special gift, we'll also send you the Chevy Truck Milestones Collection, a series of print illustrations commemorating the 80th anniversary of Chevy trucks. Just call 1-800-879-2946.
I like to think people can count on me. It's a value I was raised with. That probably has something to do with why I drive a Chevy truck and why I bought an identical one from my dad. If you need to get a job done, Chevy's the truck to do it in. Hi, I'm Cal Ripken here at Chevy Truck Engineering. When I set the new record for most consecutive games played in baseball history, the media started referring to me as the Iron Man. Well, that may sound pretty cool to some people, but it really doesn't get at what matters most to me. Believe me, I'm proud of that streak. I've played in over 2,400 straight games, almost 2,500 games, but just setting a record has never been one of my goals. What I really work at is being consistent, dependable. That may not sound too glamorous, but everyone on my team knows they can count on me to give it my best effort every time. I'm there for the long haul. Same thing with Chevy trucks. They're dependable, long-lasting, and a lot of fun.
I take my boat with me, I throw the outboard motor in the back and all my camping and fishing equipment, and I still have plenty of room.
I'm involved with rodeo a lot, and I go to the National Finals Rodeo in Las Vegas.
What is it about a truck? I drive mine to the ballpark just about every day. Sometimes I haul my four-wheeler in it. And my kids, they just love it, especially my boy Ryan. He begs me to take that truck everywhere. Of course, he doesn't know about Chevy's reputation for building the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. He just knows what he likes. Smart kid, huh? Must take after his mom. Well, anyway, if you're a truck fan like Ryan and me, and if you're thinking about buying a new truck, or if you're just curious about what goes on behind the scenes at Chevrolet, don't go away. Although the 99 Silverado won't be officially introduced until this fall, during this sneak preview, we'll hear from some of the people right here at Chevy Truck Engineering, the men and women who can give us an exclusive look behind the locked doors and under the sheet metal. Of course, when it came to designing a new truck, Chevrolet had some pretty big boots to fill, their own. Silverado brand manager Kurt Ritter took this challenge pretty seriously.
A brand means to me a promise. It's a promise that you better think through, you better understand what the customer wants, you better be very straightforward in what you promise, and above all else, you better adhere to that and you better deliver that promise. Our promise is to be the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickup, something we've been for a long, long time.
Of course, the biggest challenge they face is making sure this new truck meets the tough standards of demanding customers, like me.
We use them to haul show horses around.
Chevy trucks have pulled forklifts, tractors.
We take t-shirts all over the Bay Area.
Customers were invaluable to the development of this pickup truck.
It's really important to me to have a reliable truck.
Talking to Chevy, man, you don't have to do nothing better.
Don't succumb to the frilly things that a truck doesn't need. Stay with the basics.
Taking this input from customer research and transforming it into a new truck was the job of Chief Engineer Ken Sohocki.
Our consumers had no problems telling us what things they would find troubling and which things they felt were absolutely essential to make the truck successful. It's a rather simple task. write it down, listen to what they said to us, and make sure you execute it.
Sounds easy enough, but what do you do when your research tells you that people like the truck just the way it is? Well, for starters, you don't mess with what works. In redesigning the proven Vortec V8 engine, the team had an interesting philosophy.
The best design is the simplest that works. It's pretty hard for me to argue with Albert Einstein.
I have a Vortec engine, I know that. That's the only thing my husband chose on the truck.
Now, with this new Vortec engine, it's pretty straightforward. It's gonna start.
For the engine, I've never felt insecure at all, because it just goes. It's just so dependable.
We haven't gone to complex systems like multi-valves, turbocharging, multi-cam, overhead cam designs. What we've done is we've built on the heritage we've had with the Chevy small block.
The key feature of the new family of Vortec V8s is the combustion process. Combustion is really important to enabling not only good refinement of the engine, but also fuel efficiency, torque, and power. An item that we added to optimize combustion is one coil per cylinder. This difference from the current design, which has one coil for all 8 cylinders.
With the new design of the Vortec family, what we have is a capability to generate a tremendous amount of more horsepower per liter than what we have on the current family of engines.
The new design features longer and larger cylinder head bolts. This enables better clamp load on the cylinder head gasket for dependability.
The engine sounds great. It performs great, it's responsive, and has more than enough power for passing or towing.
Towing power is very important to our customers. A flat torque curve is what towing power really is.
You need a broad, flat torque curve to provide the low-end torque to get the load moving, but then the mid-range torque, which will help you accelerate and merge onto the highway, and also provide the power you need at cruising speeds. But you need the high-end torque to provide the massive amounts of horsepower that you need to climb the interstate grades or pass semis or other less capable trailering combinations. All the torque in the world won't help you if you don't have the proper transmission. And what we've done with the new Chevy Silverado transmission is added a tow-haul mode. When you're towing a trailer, you engage that tow-haul switch, and it'll delay your upshifts. In a hillier region, the tow-haul will keep you from shifting repeatedly from third to fourth to third to fourth. It'll maintain that third gear a little longer. You can get a lot of shift busyness without the tow haul mode.
We hope you're enjoying this 1999 Silverado sneak preview. Remember, you can call anytime to request advance information or receive any of our other special offers. And stay tuned to see how Silverado stands up to the competition.
Silverado's not all about raw power. It's also about the stopping distance and the performance that we get out of the new brake system.
We've been deer hunting in it and down canyons and up hills.
I take the kids back and forth to school and I have them with me most of the time.
I'm particularly pleased with the ABS system.
The Silverado will be the only light-duty truck that comes with not only four-wheel ABS standard, but also four-wheel disc standard.
Ken Sohocki came to us and challenged us with a very aggressive brake wear life interval.
One of our objectives up front was to double the brake life.
We're getting 4 times the life of our current vehicle. And what this means to the customer is if he's getting 12,000 miles because he's got heavy duty city traffic, aggressive driving kind of usage, he'll get better than 48,000 with this brake system.
So here's a case where you lay out what would seem to be an extremely difficult challenge and this team just overachieved.
The Silverado brake pad is thicker than the competing product. This means more life for the customer. This is value. The calipers on the Silverado are larger than both current and the competing product. The rear brakes are disc. They have a ventilated rotor. Some manufacturers skimp and put a solid rotor. We went all the way with ventilated rotors to better absorb the heat, especially in trailering situations.
Well, anybody who's towed a trailer knows that braking is one of the most important aspects of trailer towing.
We've used some new and different tools in the new Silverado brakes. One is DRP, which is an acronym for dynamic rear proportioning. DRP results in smoother, shorter stopping distances for all varied loading conditions, even repeated braking.
Especially when you get over bumpy roads and the hitch weight from the trailer can change the load conditions dramatically as you try to brake. Dynamic rear proportioning will smooth all that out and optimize the front to rear brake balance and overall prolong your brake life.
To show you just how well we've integrated some of this stuff, not only the powertrain but the brake system, I asked the guys to run a little demonstration.
For the past couple days, we've been out here on the test track evaluating the 0 to 80 to 0 performance of our new Chevy Silverado against the competitive Ford and Dodge trucks. Sometimes to help evaluate our vehicles in a more real world type of situation, we push our vehicles beyond the normal envelope on the test track. We've been evaluating the new Silverado against comparably equipped Ford and Dodge products. Engines, transmissions, axle ratios, tire size. We're testing at the curb weight of the vehicle, and we've accounted for a 250-pound driver. And we're also using the standard brake systems. The three vehicles accelerate rapidly from 0 to 80 miles an hour when an alarm goes off, and then the drivers immediately brake to zero. On the 0 to 80 mile an hour portion of the test, the Chevrolet is outperforming the Dodge and the Ford by approximately 2 seconds, and the Chevrolet stops 200 feet sooner than either the Ford or the Dodge.
The brake system on the Chevy Silverado is world class.
If you're enjoying this sneak preview of the 1999 Chevy Silverado, call to receive even more information as it becomes available, or tell us what you'd like to see in future Chevy truck programs. But don't go away. Next, you'll be seeing some impressive Silverado features from the inside out.
An outstanding powertrain, an outstanding brake system. Not a bad way to build a world-class truck. Especially since engine and brake performance are two of the most important ways customers measure a truck's durability and dependability. Of course, the Silverado engineering team didn't stop there. To meet their own stringent durability goals, they analyzed everything from the asphalt up.
Well, I think the engineers on this program, really, they're dyed-in-the-wool, salt-of-the-earth people themselves. Just like the full-size pickup customers they're engineering the trucks for. They try to understand what this truck might be subjected to during its lifetime, and not only its first lifetime, its first ownership, but its second and its third and its fourth.
I got this truck on a job in Las Vegas. From Las Vegas, I went to Santa Fe. From Santa Fe, I went to Mexico.
From Portland, Oregon, I've hauled four horses all the way. Well, we hauled them here to Santa Barbara.
From Mexico, I went to Carson City, Nevada. From Carson City, Nevada, I went to Sacramento.
I'm an admirer of Death Valley. I just came back last week, by the way.
I went to Vail, Colorado. From Vail, Colorado, I went to Sun Valley, Idaho. From Sun Valley, Idaho, I went to Phoenix, where we did three jobs.
Vehicles aren't successful by sitting in conference rooms and talking about them. Vehicles become successful by getting in the trucks and spending some time riding them when it's hot, riding them in extreme cold weather, riding them when at altitude, riding them with trailers attached to them, loading and unloading cargo yourself. Using the truck just like a consumer uses it is exactly the way that we helped to make this thing the best we could.
I think to the customer that's out in the range, he certainly wants his vehicle to be durable. He doesn't want it to break down where he doesn't have anybody to help him with it.
The Chevy frame design team understood right at the get-go that the price of entry into ensuring a good, durable, full-size truck is to have a solid, structurally sound frame. And to do that, we had to ensure that we were able to meet 20% higher durability requirements than anything we had done in the past.
We're making the frame smarter by leveraging new technology, new techniques, and new manufacturing opportunities.
Well, in your house, if the basement is not poured correctly, if the foundation's not correct, if it's not framed correctly, you, over time, will experience floor squeaks. Your house will experience a lot of creaks and groans due to the weather and strong winds and so forth. It's the same with the vehicle.
It has to be strong because it's the backbone of the truck. It's what carries all the load. Basically, it has to be designed smart.
Our new frame is a three-piece, fully welded construction.
The front frame is box section. We're using hydroform components to minimize the amount of welding and propensity for durability problems.
And the process is taking a tube, pre-bending it in the general shape of the frame, and then putting it into a press where the water is pressurized inside the tube at 20,000 psi, expands into the shape of the die, and you have a tube or a rail made without welding.
Which basically keeps mass off the vehicle, allowing greater payload for the customer.
One of the things that really matters in doing a frame is how it reacts to a collision. We have designed in crush caps. With hydroform technology, we can get this consistency in the geometry, which in turn allows the crush cap to go ahead and fold within itself, absorbing a significant amount of energy. Here's a cap that's been crushed, and notice how it folds the front part of the frame right into the back part of the frame.
On our mid and rear rails, we're using high-strength steel to allow our customers to enjoy the same load-carrying capability they have traditionally become used to, while minimizing the amount of mass. This translates to increased payload for the customer, because we don't have to carry as much mass on the frame. The desired outcome for the customer is to not sense anything. We want the frame to be totally transparent to the customer, because if the frame is performing properly, like a foundation in your house, you never notice it.
That statement applies to many aspects of the 1999 Silverado. If the engineering team has really done its homework, the customer will never notice the benefits. How do you notice an absence of problems? Of course, years ago, pickup owners wouldn't fault a truck for a stiff ride or a few squeaks and rattles. It sort of added character. But as the Chevy truck team can tell you, times have changed.
There's an awful lot of people that are coming into the full-size pickup world now that were formerly of the utility world or even the car world.
It's not like driving a truck to me.
It just runs very, very smooth. It runs like an automobile.
I feel comfortable. I feel at home in my truck.
What customers will notice about the cab is the ride is as quiet as many passenger cars.
We call that structural feel in terms of a body. And of course, the body has to work together with the frame and improve stiffness there in order to get the overall feeling of seclusion and isolation that our customers really want.
So full-size pickups have had to evolve over the years to have a much more pleasant cabin, cab area, and a more pleasant ride and handling characteristics.
In this cab, we've provided additional space for the passenger and driver to enter. In fact, the floor is actually an inch lower step in height than the current truck.
I'm 6'5", weigh about 230 pounds, and it's important to me to be able to keep my Western hat on when I'm in a truck.
I'm 5 feet tall, and sitting in the seat with the multi-position seat it is, I'm always bringing it up where my husband's bringing it down.
We wanted to make sure that we accommodated 98% of the driving population, which is a wide range of people, from very small, lightweight people to very tall and heavier weight people.
The number one thing we could do for our consumers was to improve the use of the seat belts.
So as you can see, I'm only using one hand here, and I can easily snap in the seat belt, and here it's in the right place. Another important part of the seat belts is that they were designed to always stay in the same relationship to the shoulder.
The cab design is the first step in creating a great driver and passenger environment. Whether it's improved stiffness or more room, that's where it all starts.
In the case of the instrument panel area, for example, the front of the truck is actually 60% stiffer than the current truck, and this results in reduced squeaks and rattles.
Our customers have told us how important it is to have a comfortable and roomy back seat area.
They're going to notice that second seat area is something that you can sit in. Not like a tin soldier, but you can sit in and be comfortable.
To do that, we've extended the seat bottom cushion, raised the seat back, tilted the seat back angle, as well as increased the amount of leg room, and we have almost an inch of extra headroom. You might think I'm in a real pickup truck, but actually I'm in what we call an environmental cubing fixture, which we use in engineering to verify the fit of all of our interior components.
How can we do better when we're already the highest resale? We already have the most satisfied owners and the best long-term quality. Well, you make the truck bigger, faster, stronger, and smarter.
Our customers told us that it was very important for them to know what's going on in their vehicle.
Well, with the new truck, we give them more information so they can take the greatest care of that truck and really maintain the highest resale value and make sure that that truck lasts a long time and in keeping with their high standards.
We actually tell the customer at that time he is low on coolant, and then as the temperature elevates, we'd actually show him that the engine was becoming hot, and we give him a message with a red background as opposed to amber when it's a caution. And then we actually reduce engine power to allow the customer to proceed to safety under a low coolant condition or a hot temperature condition.
I mean, these people really, really take to heart what they're working on, which is America's best, most dependable, longest lasting full-size pickup. They're not working on just a gadget or any pickup truck. They're working on a Chevy truck. And they take that to heart every day when they come to work.
We wanted to make sure that we were going to bring something to the customers that exceeded their expectations of dependability and long life. And we did that by making sure in our test programs we pushed the limits.
In fact, we've driven and ridden our seats over 5,400 hours on road to date.
We've tested extensively at our proving grounds in Milford, Michigan and Mesa, Arizona, and a lot of on-road testing as well. We've been through the deserts in Utah, California, and Phoenix. We've gone to Lake Tahoe, up Death Valley, Baker Grade in California, which is a 15-mile continuous grade on an interstate highway.
We go to the hottest places like Death Valley. We go to the highest mountains, and we test at Pikes Peak, and we go to the coldest places.
We induce braking, twist, potholes, vertical loading, severe off-road events, anything a normal customer would do, and then we go beyond.
There's a lot of missed soccer games. There's a lot of late dinners. To execute a new product program like this takes a lot of dedication, and that dedication is reflected throughout the team.
We hope you're enjoying this sneak preview. There's still time to call us and receive advance information on this exciting new 1999 Chevy Silverado. Request a VHS copy of this show or reserve a set of the Chevy Truck Milestones. Have any suggestions for future programming? Let us know. And stay tuned. A sneak peek at the new Silverado is just minutes away.
You know, listening to these engineers talk about testing the new Silverado on Pikes Peak and in Death Valley and all the remote corners of the country, I say, wait a minute, that doesn't sound like work. That sounds like fun. Well, I suppose it's not much different from my job. There's nothing I'd rather do than play baseball, that's for sure. Still, there are days when, thanks to a nagging injury, a pulled muscle or something, I'm tempted to slack off. But for me, that's really not an option. Likewise, if the manager wants me to play third base instead of short, if that's where he thinks I can contribute the most, then that's where I'll be. I suspect it's that way with most pickup owners. You just do whatever it takes to stay in the game and stay at the top of your game because you know someone's counting on you to do it. Whether you're a ball player, a construction worker, a busy parent, or in this case, a Chevy truck engineer.
My daughter is going to get married next year, and they already told me that their first new vehicle when they're married is going to be a new Chevrolet Silverado.
I have a daughter, and it'll be very easy for her to get back here. I kind of envisioned that as we designed the cab. The real people will be using the back seat, not just a cardboard mock-up.
But one consistent theme came back time and time and time again is that Chevy truck is in the business of things that really matter in this world.
Things that matter. For pickup owners, that pretty much says it all. I hope you've enjoyed this sneak preview of the 1999 Chevy Silverado. I know I've learned a thing or two, and I have to admit that after what I've seen today, I can't wait to try Silverado on for size. I mean, hey, Baltimore isn't exactly Pikes Peak, but there's still a few places where a guy can put his truck to the test. Of course, it'll be some months before Silverado hits Chevy showrooms. In the spirit of our sneak preview, however, Chevrolet has agreed to give you a look at a Silverado prototype that was recently revealed at the North American International Auto Show in, where else, Detroit.
styling perspective, our customers don't wear designer suits, and they probably don't want a designer truck. What we've got is timeless styling.
Timeless styling, a commitment to build on their reputation for dependable, long-lasting trucks. It looks like the folks at Chevy Truck have been paying attention.
With the Silverado, we wanted to give our owners a truck that when they sat in it, they looked around and they drove it, that they could really think, Chevrolet really understood me and what I wanted and what I needed.
What we have here is a bigger, faster, stronger, smarter version of the world's longest lasting, most dependable truck.
On behalf of all the men and women who stand behind the 1999 Chevy Silverado, thanks for your attention. We'll leave you with one last thought.
Years now, where they go? 20 years, I don't know. I sit and I wonder sometimes where they've gone. And sometimes late at night, when I'm bathed in the firelight, the moon comes calling a ghostly way, and I recall
Chevy, the most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road.